Welcome back to the Gusky. I'm Gray, and today we have more filler programming for you. In other words, Rome Total War. So, if you remember last time, we captured Ebera, which, for some dumb reason, when I got on here to record this episode, I was thinking we needed to take these two settlements still. And that was going to be our project for today, but clearly we accomplished that last time. So, that's that. We want to see, we're pretty much ready to just transition right into this shit and hit the end turn button, which is what we're going to do, and get going here. So, yeah, there's nothing really to talk about. Like I said, we're almost done with the Iberian Peninsula, and once we are done with that, we are going to transition over here to the Italian Peninsula. As you see, we've got armies kind of ready, willing, and waiting here. We are going to need some spies up in that area, though. I'm going to have to go figure out where the fuck we got them hiding and bring them over there to do some harm. And then I think we'll be fine, because we're going to really need to scout the shit out of that place. You are a general, and where in the hell are you? You're over here. Baricus is dead. All right, cool. You are Magnet Hunted. I'm going to go with you. You're Fist Famulcar. All right. So, what should we do here? We need, population surplus. Let's go. Look at that, now we can build the last thing here, or whatever. I don't know. Anyhow, how are we doing on food? I think we got plenty of food available, so we're gonna go ahead and make some monies here. So, yeah. We have a decent amount of money coming in now. That's pretty good. If you can get close to about 4,000, something like that, you're in a good place. Alalia has something to build. What should we build? I think we should build a muster field to give us a little bit of a garrison here, because we're kind of really going to want to hold on. Oh, look at that. We have the cultural control over this region now. That's good. That's very good. Like I said, we're going to kind of launch a two-pronged attack by dropping a couple armies over here, and then at least moving one, I think, through the lower portion of the Italian Peninsula and stuff like that, because these places are, you know, undefended, basically. I mean, you got this sitting right here, and it's just begging for us to come and kick some ass and take some names. So, that's really what we're looking at there. Scourge of Russia. We have, let me do that. Yeah, we only have one spy. Jesus Christ, no dignitaries or anything either. Oh, I think we're gonna make you over here. No, that's not what I want. That's what I want. I need a spy. Let's go with you. And then we can probably recruit. Yeah, I think we're gonna do that, actually. Let's recruit some. Let's recruit a dignitary. I'll just go with him. He's got a cool name. That's not what I want. There we go. And we'll go with Zaba. A really strange looking whatever they are. I mean, hell, in all honesty, we could probably just launch and attack Lilibium as is, and go from there if you really wanted to. However, I want to spy over there first before we do anything. It's always a good practice, and this game especially, always have a spy. You always need a spy. You always need to know what the hell is around that corner, because if you don't, the second you don't, it's when you get fucking boned. I'm not gonna lie, you get just royally screwed sometimes when it comes to that shit. So, we are at war with pretty much everyone here. Numantia, you are going to be, you're pretty much fine. So we might go ahead and move the walls of Bursa. Let's move them there and then attack next turn. Our wonderful little spy. How about you go around here, see if there's anyone lurking in the weeds? Nobody that we can tell. That's good. You need a few more turns still to kind of recoup your losses here. And then we will move on and capture. Oh, this. Oh my god, I need to build some shit, don't I? Just goddamn. Goddamn. Alright, so we got that going. Should probably build. Hey, you're converting that, so. Let's go ahead and go in the muster field so we can have a bunch of troops, and then we'll kind of go a different direction with that one there. Alright, that's what I think we're going to do right there. That'll leave us a decent amount of cash, and probably by the time all the shit here is built in Ebra, in two turns, we'll be able to move west and snag Olisipo, and then we've got, aside from Numantia, Ericillum, we've got one more little settlement to snag, and that's Brigantium. I think we'll do that at some point as well. I think we'll take the army that's going to be taking Olisipo and just run them straight up there. As you can see, you can just run them straight up here and take them. I think that's what we'll go ahead and do. It's actually not that long of a walk. Looks pretty long, but it goes pretty quick. Jesus Christ. Counter the rumors. Fuck you. Don't mess with my bitches. Of course, that absolutely kills our cash flow. But hey, it is what it is. So, we'll go ahead and take Ericillum now. And there we go. Alright. Had to think for a second, clearly. No. Assaults. That's one thing that's kind of strange in this game. I haven't really had all that much success besieging settlements. It's much more effective, I think, in this game to just assault them. I remember Medieval 2, it was really costly sometimes when it came to troops. I mean, it cost you a lot of troops basically to just take a settlement and assault it as opposed to, you know, squeeze the life out of it. But now that they have the attritional losses on your side as you besiege a city, it really hurts us just as much as it hurts them sometimes. So, especially if they sit there and they can hold out forever, you know, 6, 7, 8 turns, it's something that really sucks. So, like I said, I kind of just go ahead and assault everything if you haven't noticed already. It's, number one, quicker. Number two, doesn't give them a chance to bring recruitments into the equation, or bring reinforcements into the equation. And it's just, and quite honestly, I think it's less costly when it comes to your, troops. Especially when you get to fight these guys, you know, out on the field, which I don't like as much. I mean, I don't know, I think in all my hours of playing the Total War games, fighting in the field is just something that I've done a lot of. Oh, we'll wait one more time, see if the fog lifts. There we go. The only reason I really want to do that, okay. Oh, Jesus, what am I doing? Wow. Alright, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Alright, I want you guys, fuck it, we'll just leave you guys as you are. Oops, there you are, I want to start the battle, not fucking staying here. Alright, I guess we'll just start walking that way. Just, this is one thing that irritates me. It's like, I don't like when they, like, I don't know if you noticed in the loading screen, it said that they sally forth to attack you. So they're coming out to attack me, is the way I understand it, even though I chose to assault, and yet they'll just sit here and hang out. It's kind of annoying. I really wish that I had more of an opportunity more often to play defensively out in the open field. Because, I mean, when you assault settlements, you're the aggressor, so it's just one of those things where it's like you just like something to, you know, like a little variety. In case you haven't noticed, that's something that I like a lot of. I like variety. I like things not being always the same. I know, like, I talk about a lot of shit like that in a lot of my LPs, specifically the ones that I do by myself. That's just something that, you know, it's just, like I said, it's just something I like to have. I don't like doing the same shit over and over again. That's not as much fun to me. It's also why I kind of like certain games that I just kind of get tired of. One of them specifically being like Zelda. It's weird, like I grew up on Zelda, like no lie, straight up grew up on that shit. Played it all the time when I was a kid. In fact, that was, A Link to the Past was a game that actually got me into gaming, in all honesty. And in truth though, like I said, it's just now I can't play those games. Basically after Ocarina of Time and Majora's Mask, that's it for me. I'm done. I've played enough of them, and I'm like, ah, it's just the same over and over. You know, and I got friends that play them and stuff like that. And just like, oh, I played Wind Waker too. Yeah, Wind Waker. I forgot about that one there for a second. You know, like I said, just get tired of them. I'm just done doing that shit. It was just the same thing over and over, and nothing was different. Nothing was changed. It was just always what it was. Like I said, it's just one of those things that kind of gets old after a while, and like I said, I like a little variety sometimes. And hopefully that comes through on the channel too, because I mean, I play a lot of different shit. That's probably a little annoying. I mean, there are certain things that I play a lot of, you know, Pokemon and whatnot. You know, this game, like I said, I played a lot of this in my time. So I figured I'd go ahead and include it, you know, in the LPs and all that shit that we do here. Something fun. Like I said, I haven't beaten this game yet, so I've always come close. Like I said, I always get real close to beating Rome 2, and then I end up just abandoning the campaign. Not intentionally, it's just one of those things that happens, you know, like when you play a RPG or something and you get like all the way up to the end and then you're like, alright, I've played all that I want to play of this game, and you're done. Alright, end battle. Wonderful. Easy shit. Jesus, they did kill quite a few guys, though. Oh, we do need to upgrade these fuckers, don't we? That'll come in time. Hopefully we're on the... Looks like we're on the cusp of having a lot of money in this game. And once you start bringing in a pretty hefty paycheck every turn, you're gonna be well off. And it'll be much easier to get going. And in quite honesty, you still have to have some discipline. Because if you have done this, where you just start like upgrading the shit out of all your buildings, but you don't have the food to support it, and then your fucking army starts starving and shit. Yeah, I've done that. It's like, oh, I got all this money, I can just upgrade the shit out of everything, but everything costs food, and if you don't pay attention to that, you don't have enough food. You end up starving out your own culture. Kind of sucks, but it's not too difficult to bounce back from, at least in my opinion. Like I said, I've done that a couple times. On the same file, too. Let's just get a little carried away upgrading all my buildings. That noise you probably hear is Frodo. He found one of his little balls with the bell inside of it, so he's like, fuck it, I'm playing with this shit. And he's in the other room, by the way. That's how loud the damn thing is. But anyhow, so that's that. We now have Arakilum. Hopefully, surprisingly, the Gallic Confederation or whoever they are. I don't know who they are. That's one thing that is a little confusing. The Gallic Confederation and like German confederations and stuff like that. This symbol will stay the same, but the name will change. So I don't know what it is at this point. I wasn't paying attention. I think it's still the other one, though, whatever the hell they start out as. The Arverni or something like that. But, they must have war somewhere else then, because we saw those armies earlier, and it seems that they've just abandoned the Iberian. entirely. They've abandoned their settlements. They did have that army that was camped out in front of by Tarraco, entrenched out there for a while, and that's up and gone, as we know. Yeah, it is the Gallic Confederation now. Like I said, a little confusing when the shit changes. I remember the first time I saw this, like, oh wait, I thought they were fucking something else. I didn't even know they could turn into, like, confederations and shit. But they can, haha. So, alright, we got this guy. What else can we put on you guys? Ooh, that might be useful. That might be useful as well. We'll go with that. I do love all the upgrades from the armies. I think that's fucking awesome. I love that shit. I love it, I love it, I love it, I love it, I love it. So now we have a... Let's see, can we secure promotion for any of these fuckers so we can get going here? Can't for you, can't for you, can for you too. Well, let's secure your promotion, my good friend, because we need more control over this shit. I'll do it for you too, because I think I want to do that. Alright, now we can convert some shit, hopefully. Oh, Jesus. Alright, we'll just tear that fucker down, and we will turn you into that. How's that sound? Which one should we build? Let's build Eshman. I don't think we have very many of those. You are Libyan Peltis. I thought we had late Libyan Peltis or something like that. I thought this was late Carthaginians and late Libyans. Huh. Why can't we upgrade those? That's strange. Because we can upgrade. What do we have built here? Do we need something built? That's probably it right there. Ooh. Ooh. Ooh, we need to build some Amphite barracks. Yeah, that's what. Oh, no. It's the Amphite's African. Oh, we can build African elephants! Oh my god! Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god, oh my god! It's gonna be so fun. It's gonna be so fun. Fun, 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 fun. I'll probably get like a shit ton of those goddamn elephants killed. Because I don't know how to use them, because I've never used them. So, yeah, you'll probably witness a lot of elephantine genocide on my part. But it'll be unintended. I apologize. I truly do apologize. But they're just so cool. I mean, how badass is that? To ride a fucking elephant in the battle and kick ass on an elephant. I mean, it's one thing to ride in on a horse. I mean, don't get me wrong. Horses are cool. But elephants just... I mean, talk about upping the fucking ante, right? I mean, goddamn. Like I said, and then the thing is... I've never had a chance, never, ever, 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 ever had a chance to use any elephantine units in Rome or Rome 2 or anything. So I'm really excited about that. And that's also one of the big reasons why I wanted to play as Carthage. I wanted to have something new, something I can, you know, something tangible, something I can play around with that's new to me. Oh, Sapidam. Sapidam is dead. Bye-bye, Sapidam. Well, let's go with Tharsa, because that sounds like a Final Fantasy name, doesn't it? I'm going to put you on some damn elephants, because I like fucking elephants. I mean, if I could have an elephant, like, not as a pet, but as a mode of transportation, I would so fucking have one. Not kidding. Not kidding at all. Straight up. My garage would house an elephant. What the fuck? I don't want mercenaries. Although I do want to kind of look at mercenary Italian swordsmen. How can we get Italian swordsmen all the way out here? That's interesting. Those are faction exclusive, though. Same with the Numidian nobles and the Numidian cavalry. What else we got here? Celtic light horse. Mercenary noble horse. And noble fighters. Jesus, those are pretty damn good. They just didn't cost so much to upkeep. Would be nice. Yes, would be nice. Alright. We can build whatever the fuck we want to build here. So let's build, actually. Let's go with a... farm, because I think we need some more of that shit. Let us build an Oplite barracks, because we need to start upgrading some of that shit, because we're going to need them. I think we're going to really want that shit for the Italian peninsula, really. Honestly, I think that's going to be a thing we're going to really need. So, always worth investing some time and money into that, and we can just go ahead and take... How are you on garrison? Your garrison is full, so let's just fucking do it. Now we have Olisipo here shortly. Ooh, I have a decent barracks. Decent amount of stuffs. But not too much for us. Not too much for us. Because we have badassery incarnate. These guys right here. These peltasts are the shit. I'm sitting here thinking maybe I should take those, keep those, hold those back so they don't get killed, but I don't think they're gonna, I don't think they'll come anywhere close to damaging them that much. One thing I do like about this game are the little tiles they have for the units. I think they're really cool. Number one, I really like the art style. Number two, you can actually kind of get an idea of how armored and what type of unit it is just by the tile. Like, these are going to be light infantry. You know, same thing with these guys, you know, ranged. I mean, it's all pretty obvious stuff, and I like that. I think that's cool. You know, and you see the heavier infantry that actually has a little bit of a chest plate there, you know, and you can see ours that are, I think ours classify as heavy. I think there's four or five classifications, like light heavy, or light heavy, light, medium, should be heavy, very heavy, and I think super heavy. I think. So, you, like I said, you can kind of get an idea of the weight classes that they have for units, and their, like I said, their usefulness, not usefulness, but what uses they have. Heavy infantry, obviously, are the ones that are, like, going to be very, very resistant to, like, cavalry and shit like that. So, that's something to always consider when you play this game. And, yeah, I think we're just gonna fucking barge in there like we are here. I'm not really in the mood to try and encircle them or anything like that. Just not. I'm gonna double line this shit. Because I can right now. And you guys. I know they do have. Oh, fuck. I gotta start the battle, don't I? I know they do have boats there, as we see. And I want you to go there, and I want you guys to go there, because they're just all swordsmen, I think. So our horses might be okay, just kicking your ass. As long as they're not, they shouldn't be heavy. That's one thing too. Most of these marine units that disembark are usually pretty, not weak, but just usually light. Fuck. Damn spears. But that's okay, like I said, we're gonna have these guys right here. And these guys will go up and be supported by them. Maybe we should have you stop right there, because you're gonna outpace everything. That's something too, like their weight class determines their speed and stuff like that. So if you've got, you know, light, like these are light missile infantry, very heavy spears. Jesus, I did not know they were very heavy. I thought they were just heavy. But that is what they are. Alright, you guys all... Alright, you guys are... All off the boats. So we will then turn... Our spearmen... You see, these guys are light spear infantry, so they'll move a lot quicker. A lot more fleet-footed, if you will. Go. Go, Plata. Go. Seriously, where are you two assholes going? There we go. Run at me. Oh, good. Our ranged units over there aren't getting attacked yet. I think the cavalry will just sit this one out. Where are you guys going? Like, you don't see these fuckers running around you? Why don't you take them on? Go throw your shit at them. Throw your shit like monkeys. I know I said I think we were gonna, you know, have the cavalry wait this one out, but I decided not to. Why are all of you not engaging? That needs to be a thing. You all need to get involved. The vetting quarters. Alright, there we go. What in the fuck are they doing? See, this is one thing too that sucks. Is we turn our back to them and then we start getting fucking nailed by all their ranged shit. Not good. Does not do good for morale and really hurts your you take quite a few losses. And that is one thing that makes the Lusitani pretty difficult. This unit needs to go. These guys need to go. These veteran shield warriors. Okay, good. Now turn your asses around and go that way. Throw your shits, please. Close the distance. Kill shit. I am pretty happy with the way we've been able to handle the Lusitani and being early part of the game. I think, like I said, I've had... They're just difficult. There's a lot of good things, like I said, going for them. The fact that they've had all the ranged units or the ability to toss ranged shit at people. You know, with their heavy melee units and stuff like that and all that good shit. One thing they are seriously lacking, in my honest opinion, though, is a decent amount of good spear units. They have a lot of medium spears, as far as I can tell, and that seems to really hamper them quite a bit and leaves them rather susceptible to cavalry and the like. But the fact that they can sit here and throw shit at me before I even get to them makes them rather difficult to deal with sometimes. So like I said, I mean, really, there's a lot of things going for them. If you actually play with these guys, I'm sure someone would have a lot of fun and, you know, like I said, have a pretty decent game with them. All right, go, horses, go. Just kill them. They're the only ones that are left, really, in the ranged units, and they're routing as we speak, and they're done. And that's it. Now we have Olisipo. And now the Lusitani are pretty much done, I think, in this, I think they're pretty much done in this game. I would venture to say they are. Because I don't think they have any other settlements. I would suspect we'll get some sort of counterattack somewhere while they'll try to take a summit because they need a settlement. Otherwise, they'll starve and all that good shit. But I don't see them doing so. I think we've been able to take out the majority of their armies. So they don't really have much for firepower. They'll probably recruit some mercenaries somewhere and try that way, but we'll see. And like I said, I'm a little surprised we haven't seen anything from the Gallic Confederation yet. I mean, we haven't seen any counterattack or anything like that, which is very rare and very strange. It's very strange to just have a faction that you just walk through like this. I mean, like we have so far. It's just, They must be at war with someone else up north, where that's taking the bulk of their resources and military might, which is fine with us. Because for once, we will then be able to backdoor the enemy. How appropriate is that, I ask you? How appropriate is that? It's very appropriate, if you ask me, with all the fucking times they try to do that shit. Bastards. But anyhow, now that we're pretty much done, I think we will go ahead and try to finish up the Iberian Peninsula in this episode, and then I think I'll stop there, and then we will begin marshalling troops in the east and assaulting the Italian peninsula. Obviously, we need to upgrade a few buildings over there so we can recruit shit like elephants and stuff like that. Have a little bit better garrisons, because like I said, I think we're going to need that. I'm not sure what Rome has in terms of how far along their troops are technologically. Typically in Rome, the first one, they would be pretty advanced, especially late in the game. They'd be really advanced, but now I'm not sure. I know they had some really strong units when I was playing with my whatever the fuck it's called. My German Confederation campaign. I know they had. How in the fuck did I not build you a brood defensive artillery? Wait, artillery? Oh. That's the thing I have to research. Fucking dummy. Alright, we will build. Yeah, we'll build fishes. We will build the fishes. And it has no monies. Not enough monies anyway. Alright, so we'll probably wait on those till next turn. Yeah, that sounds good. Of course, we don't really need anything to garrison troops here. Because I think we have... Yeah, we have a garrison at Numantium, so I think they're going to have a tough time getting to us. So... That's that. Alright, so we will end our turn there. Like I said, I'm not sure at this stage of the game how tough Rome will be. Ooh, there we go. There we go, that's what I was expecting. Ooh, did you see that? They have some peoples. They had to have snagged some mercenary troops. Had to. No way they'd be able to make anything otherwise. So. Alright. So what? Damn, making some monies now. Thank you, Frodo, for making an appearance, another appearance, continued appearance on my LP. You know what's fucked up? Is that guy never plays with the little ball. He always digs goddamn dog food on the dog dish and plays with that. It's like the one time he plays with the fucking ball is right now. Right fucking now. Yeah, I don't think he's gonna even have a chance. He should have, yeah, that's what I thought. Mercenary troops. Oh, shit. You wanna know what I fucking forgot to fucking do? God fucking fuck. Fuck. You go here. Ugh, I hate how they do the fucking pathing on these guys. Where the fuck did she go? Seriously? Where in the fuck are you going? You are seriously going all the way around? How dumb are you? Like I said, the pathing. The fucking pathing. Just goddamn awful sometimes in this game. And it's... Yeah, just... Oh my god. Like, why? Why would you do that? what possesses you to say, hey, I know it'll work. I'll go around the whole goddamn world to get there instead of going, traveling the shortest path possible. Because that's smart, right? That is smart. That is fucking smart. Anyway, alright, what in the fuck do we need? We need to build something over here. Siege tower, armor siege. Alright, elephant training. Oh, yes, we want that. We want that. Yes, we fucking do. Alright. It was a building of our central grain warehouse. Alright, so it's not there. I don't remember what the fuck it's called. I'm just... Exotic animal handling. So cool. So cool. Jesus. I love a lot of this late game shit that you build. It's really... Or research. It's really cool. Alright, so we need canal and dam systems. It's probably a good idea to start working on some of these. Alright, what in the fuck do I need to build for you? Because I did not... Did not see it. Improved defensive artillery, battering ram. So you are the weapons and armor. You're the armor one and shield. Oh, decisions. All right. We are gonna convert you. No, we don't even need to do that. I'm gonna destroy both of you. Fuck you both. You're both worthless. Worthless. Complete shit, I say. Complete shit. Alright. So we are going to do nothing over here right now, I think. We are gonna start working on the siege shit. Battering ram, armored siege unit, siege tower, your battering ram. Armored siege, improved defensive artillery. Oh, damn. Need to get some shit done over here with this siege shit. Actually, no, we're gonna go with the shortest one, the one that's shorter. We might want that too before we go into the Italian peninsula, because once we go in there, we'll probably get some counterattacks and all that good shit. Now, what do we want to do about this guy? Not much of an army, but he has the one goddamn thing that irritates me beyond all reason. You know what I can do? Mayhaps we can... Fuck, never mind. Stab your feet. Opportune failure. In other words, we didn't do anything right there. Alright, so we've got Arakilim. All your shit's almost done. Fuck. He is not... Wow, really? He's not gonna be able to get to anything yet. Well, that's good, I guess. Right? That's good. That is very good. What we should do, though, is start building some fams. I'm gonna build a fam, upgrade you. That's all of our money. We'll upgrade, that's Carthage. Ooh, we can do all of those. You are Carthage, all right, you're gonna have a ton of shit built here shortly, so I'm not really all that worried about Terraconensis. Not at all, really. It's going to be the frontier territory where everyone will be defending ourselves and shit. It'd be kind of fun to... Ooh, I could actually attack him in the field and kick his ass with the peeps that are there. We'll see what he does. We'll see if he decides to, besiege Ebra or try and take the walls. Hopefully he tries and takes the walls. Tries to take. Because that'll be fun. Let's see. Where in the hell are you going? Oh, you're going to entrench your dumbass over there. I see how it is. Yeah, there you go. Oh, you got some... Oh, yay, we get to defend for fucking once. Damn, we got a lot of range shit. I'm gonna throw some shit at him, that's for sure. Alright, let's fight on the battlefield. This is fun. Although I don't know how, I may fuck this up, in all honesty. Here's why. I have not defended on these sorts of walls in a long time. Oh, I love how they start doing this, how they have the fucking two walls and shit. Oh, I love that shit. That shit's so cool. Love that shit. Love it, love it, love it, love it, love it. Although usually you end up stopping them, you know, up here or wherever, instead of, you know, letting them, you know, get into like a real epic battle where they fight their way through here and then you gotta defend then the inner cloister. I always loved doing that shit on Medieval 2. That's one of the coolest fucking cities in Medieval 2, my god. The castles, defending the goddamn castles. God, that was so fun. I love that shit. That's a game that I wish they'd remake. I know they're doing Warhammer, and that's probably going to be pretty cool. In all honesty, I love Warhammer and all that shit. I played the MMO back when it was alive. Such a fun game. Too bad EA ran it in the goddamn ground. But anyway, that's neither here nor there. But in all honesty, just the castles. Oh, the castles. I wish they'd redo Medieval 2. I love that shit. Love that shit. That was a fun game. Really was. I'm tempted to play it once in a little while, and then I go back and I play it, and I'm like, wow. The map system in the new games is much more improved, I think. I think that's where they improved the game the most, is the maps with the regions and the provinces, and I kind of like the idea, and I like the fact that you can't build everything and upgrade everything in a settlement. I kind of like it. I like the management system. I like how they've overhauled it over the years, and I enjoy it a lot more. I really do. But, shit, we're all back here. This is interesting. This is interesting. Oh, so this is where you guys are gonna fucking start out. Start out over here. Huh. I do like our architecture. It's very, medieval-ish. Medieval-looking, I should say. How do we want to do this? How do we want to do this? I think I'm gonna go with this. This way. Have you guys... up over here. Have you guys a secondary unit over here. And have you guys kind of off to the side, because I like that idea, because I like you guys just kind of sitting over here and throwing shit at them. Let's go with that. And fuck the two mobs. They can just sit back there. So where are you going to go? Where are you going to go? I do miss, though, upgrading the walls. I always thought that was fun. But, like I said, like with the different, like the barbarian, if you will, or the Germanic, or the Celtic, Iberian, I think all those have the same architecture. I really like their architecture a lot with the walls, the raised walls, and the plateaued, the city, the plateaued city. Instead of having wall that you go up and over, although, quite honestly, the walls that you have to go up and then go down, I think are a little bit tougher, although I think they're a little bit tougher to attack and a little bit tougher to defend, in my honest opinion. I find that it's easier to defend the other one because I can sit back. What I like to do is I like to sit back on the other ones, and because you have all this land out here, I like to sit back here and then let them come up the walls and go through the towers and stuff and have to get shot by the towers where I don't suffer any losses at all, whereas on the walls they can bring their ranged units up, which I don't know why they're not doing. They can bring their ranged units up and fucking shoot at you and shit. But they don't, so fuck it. Anyhow, I love defending this shit. So much more fun. So much more fun. So what I'm hoping, what I'm thinking is going to happen... Who the fuck are you? What unit is this? Oh, you're just parts of... bunch of different ones. Okay, yeah, now we're starting to throw some shit at them and stuff. Yeah, bitches. Yeah, bitches. Jesus, they're taking a ton of losses. That fucking whole unit. Oh, we're actually gonna rout them before they get up here. Nice indeed. The reason, by the way, that I do this, that I put these guys up here, so we can maintain control of these, because once they get up up the walls and they start attacking, these will continue to fire at them and shit, and that's really what we want. We don't want them to stop the walls from firing at them at all. We want that to continue. To continue being a thing, in all honesty. Now we'll kind of attack these assholes, and though I probably should have broken them up a little bit more, but wasn't quite aware. Go ahead and attack these guys. You too, you're my general unit, my capitans. What the hell's getting thrown at these guys over here? I'm just seeing shit. And that's why I wanted to put these guys kind of off in the back, because we're going to get fortunate. This is going to play right into our hands that he's going to have a real weak melee unit attack us from there. But yeah, these guys are about to rout. Oh, might have been that. Might have been those guys that came up. I just didn't pay attention. Are you guys moving now? Yeah, you guys are. Lucky for us, the cavalry will just stay out there so we don't have to go out and meet them. That was one thing that I thought was kind of broken. Back in the day, you used to have to actually go out and fucking kill them. That was kind of a pain in the ass. But, not so much anymore. Yeah, these guys should be getting it here soon. Too bad we can't fucking throw shit that far. But they'll eat it soon enough. I guess you guys help take them fuckers out. See, yeah, the fucking towers. That's one thing, like I said, it's nice to have, like, it's nice to actually use the towers yourself once in a while. I don't think you get enough chances. You fuck that. You guys get back here. Because all they've got are ranged units. We can just fall back and let them get shot at by the towers, which is what we want. Why is that open? Someone explain to me why the gates are open. So when their units fled, you can see the trail of bodies. When their units fled from atop our walls, they decided to say, hey, fuck it. We're just going to go ahead and use their doors. Because we can, apparently. So they've got just ranged units. You got slingers, which are going to shoot shit a lot farther than we are. Because we can only throw. Come on now. Get up here. Get up here. And I'm sure they will once these guys die. Oh, they're going to throw shit at me. Goddamn, fuck you. Fuck you. Yeah, get fucked by my towers, bitches. Gotta love that shit. Gotta love actually having that shit on your side for once. Like I said, defending is so much more fun in this game. I really do enjoy it. Alright, now that we're pulling them back. Haha. Punk. And he got it. Seriously, I gotta go out and get these guys. Seriously. I've had to go out and attack these fuckers. This is bullshit. Bullshit. Hero was talking about how they improved that shit too, right? Not anymore. Alright, I guess we'll go. I guess we'll go down and hopefully we can fight in the shadow of our. I doubt it though, because the fucking towers can't reach them over there. And we'll have to go get them. And fuck, they're gonna run. Ugh. Fuck, I just realized that. They're gonna run. They're gonna run like the little bitches they are. They're gonna run. God damn it. God damn, this is gonna be annoying. There we go. Let the shoosting begin, ha ha ha. Come on, Jesus Christ. This is bullshit, mind you. Bullshit. Bullshit, 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 bullshit. We'll move these assholes out first. Why don't you guys come up here? See if you can act as some bait and lure their dumb asses over here. I'm seeing how, if that'll happen with these guys. See if we can coax them in the coming out after us. See, now we're fucking taking losses just because they have to fucking make us come out here and get these assholes. That is the epitome of bullshit and irritating. And now, likely, the horses will attack, too. Please, don't run. Hold your goddamn ground. Nope. You're gonna fucking run. Like the bitches you are. It's alright, we're smart, we're not dumb, we're gonna go right after your fucking cavalry. Oh yes, shoot them, please. Shoot them hard. Frequently, often. Yes, all of you towers, kick their asses, they're gonna fucking try and attack me in the butt here. Yeah, they are. There you go. Yep, now we're gonna get swarmed by all this cavalry. Swarmed by the cavalries. Let's see if I can kind of withdraw and sucker them in the fighting closer. Let's just try it. Probably end up disastrous for us, but let's get you guys up here. That's what I want to do. Nope, you guys are just gonna sit out there and hang out, huh? I just want to be covered by my towers, that's all. Fuck, this is annoying. This is really irritating. Oh, fine, fuck it, whatever. We'll just attack you guys. This is fucking bullshit. Fuck these goddamn slingers. I hate slingers so much. Like, this is the sort of shit that's just dumb and tedious to me. Fuck it. You know what? Fuck it. I've had enough fucking arrows shooting you assholes. I'm just gonna go after these dicks. Fuck it. Go after them. Go after those horses. Doesn't matter which horses you go after. Any horses will do. Quite honestly. And once we route, if we route these guys, these fuckers should be routing. Alright, there we go. God, I fucking hate this shit. So annoying. This was so fun up until it's like, hey, fuck you, I'm just gonna stand out here. Wait for you to come get me. Yeah. That's a smart idea. No, it's not a smart idea. It's bullshit. It's bullshit, damn it. That took way too long. That should have been like 5 minutes at most. But no, it's like, hey, I got an idea. Let's make this difficult. And that should be it for that army. That they should go away and disperse into the ether and be a whole lot of nothing anymore, because they suck. But like I said, we will finish up Brigantium here soon. Good thing is we got that one army, the Gallic Confederation army that entrenched by Arachillum. That's better that they did instead of trying to like go in there and like sneak a fucking settlement like they always try to. I think they're very, very wary of our units at Arachillum, because we can just swoop in as they're trying to take Numantia, and if not, at least be a part of the battle, because we'll be close enough to reinforce, I think, or we can at least attack them if they don't get all the way to Numantia and all that good shit. So, that's that. Yeah. It's gonna be fun. That is one thing that is kind of annoying, but it makes a lot of sense when they entrench themselves. it's, like I said, it's a little annoying, because not only do they have a ton of towers and a ton of arrows shooting at you in a very small, confined kill box area, it makes it very, very tough to overcome, and a tremendous loss of life, but it is fun when you get to defend it, though. But of course, like I said, they never attack you, so they're just, you know, they're just going to be like, hey, whatever. I'll only attack you unless they have a gigantic number advantage, which I had defended before, and it is a lot of fun. Quite honestly, there's been times where that's been the only way I've been able to defend them, because they won't attack a city. Unless it's an unwalled settlement that they can just walk in and, you know, take when nobody's home. I've seen them, like, seriously, like, when you have a big empire, I've seen them, for instance, like, just walk in and just completely, like, start from the top of the Iberian Peninsula, like, where Arakilum and Tarraco and all that stuff is, walk past all that shit. Walk past all that shit. And go down to, like, something as deep as something down here, like Tingis or something. One of the unwalled settlements down there. And try and take that settlement. It's like, why? Why? What possible reason could you have for doing that other than just to piss me off? Because, you know, of course, since you can only have so many armies. Now, who died? Fagora. Ah, that's the boat guy. Yeah, the boat guy. That's how we remember these guys. The boat guy. Yeah, the bark guy. The bark guy? The boat guy. The boat guy. He's the one with the boats. Because of the armor and the weapons, we can upgrade that shit. That's right. That is right. But we're not going to do that right now. We're going to make you. And I think you. Because we can. And what we should do here now is we'll go attack him. I am going to auto-resolve because there's not much there. Sorry if that bothers you, but, yeah. Just kick him in the nuts and stab him in the heart. That's how we do. Kick him in the nuts, stab him in the heart. That's how we do it here. Alright, kill the captives. Now, we will continue moving north towards Brigantium, which I'm kind of surprised that they're not attacking, but that might be an ally of theirs. I'm not entirely sure. But, oh fuck, I forgot. Yeah, the fucking AI is kind of dumb sometimes. It pisses me off. They'll just fucking, like, just send cavalry into the teeth of the enemy and be like, go die! He doesn't care if you survive! Which, I'm like, I'd rather not, but hey, fuck it, whatever. You know what's best, right? Not. Bastards. Alright, so we'll build this fucker. Outskirts. Because we can. And we will. And that's just the way it's gonna be. Oh, are you? Are you not entrenched anymore? You are entrenched. I hate that. There's like a weird little glitch where it doesn't show up sometimes. So, alright. Arakilum, what do you have? You have built everything that you needed to build. And you have a decent garrison there. And it's full. So if we build you, I build you right here, you will not quite, well, you'll support that. So you'll support that. Alright, yeah, we will go ahead and retrain these fuckers, because we can. Get these guys updated and upgraded, because I smell a fight coming on, hopefully. What I kind of want to do is I want to entrench them. That means they shouldn't be able to go through here. Shouldn't. With the zone of control thing. Shouldn't. Being the key word there. Oh shit. You know what we need to do? Check on these fucking dummies. Yeah, because you can now go that way because you're not dumb anymore. Like, there's that spot right there where you all can go and get on the damn thing. Like, look, we landed on shit. And everything's gonna be fine. Yes, we're scouting you out. See if we can take your shit. I'll deploy your ass. Zaba, I think I'm gonna move him to the other side over here just to see. Just to make sure, like, no one sneaks around that shit. Because they don't have much there. Oh my god, Lullaby is going to be so easy to take. We should do it now. And then, yeah. So we're starting to set up, or I'm starting to set up the invasion of the East over there. That's why we've got those guys over there. Tarako, why are you pissed off? Why are you people pissed? Well, you won't be pissed for much longer, because we're going to build some things to make you happy. Oh, I know why. It's because we took him out of Arakilum. That's why. Took those guys out of Arakilum. Alright, so. We should. Actually, next turn. Should be. Yeah, that's what I thought, bitch. That's what I thought. Get out of there, fucking bitch. Yeah, fucking bitch. Alright, so. The Lusitani. They're still floating around out in the fucking water. Just bloop, 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 bloop. All by themselves. Bloop, 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 bloop. Alright. Oh. Our spy ate it. Even though she was exposed, somehow I like that. She was exposed and dies of natural causes. Alright, we're gonna go up here. I'm gonna plug this hole. Next turn is when we will go ahead and holy shit, you guys are pissed. You guys are pissed. Not for long, we hopes. Not for long. Should we build? Oh, don't fuck that. We should probably build that. That'd probably help out quite a bit. But anyhow. Next turn. That unit of horses is alright. They shouldn't have much there for us to worry about in terms of getting them wiped off the face of the planet. Yeah, Numantia is alright. Cartaginensis, Terraconensis is going to be just fine because I said so. So. Scourge of Reshef. They got cool names for the units, for their armies. I'm not gonna lie. Alright, we are getting a little long here in the tooth on this episode. However, we still have one more thing to do. Like I said, I'm trying to batch this shit together and get going as fast as fucking possible. God damn it. I fucking forgot about those guys. But, that's that. We'll be fine. I'll figure out the spy and all that. Oh, you motherfucker. I see what you're doing. You cheap little bitch. Am I going to have to station an army up there? I think I am, because you went around. He tried to be sneaky. He tried to go around and around. Now, see, the thing is, though, I don't think he can get to anything except Tarako. He may be able to get some other shit, but I don't think so. Alright, you fucking deploy. That's a boy. That a boy. You, go right here. I want to see what they got at. Oh, shit. Shit on a stick. That don't look like fun. Oh, they're not great. Those guys are decent. Those guys all suck ass. So what we might be able to do is go in there and, like, fucking blitzkrieg the shit out of Lullabium and then hang out for a little bit. Hope they come and attack us. Because I don't think, yeah, he can come down here, but I think he's got to go through Taraka to do anything. So basically what we get here is we get the chance to really screw him, I think. So I think if we turn around, come over here and just go back and forth here. But he's taking attritional losses right now because of the winter up in that mountain. It's a bitch of a mountain. Really is. You gotta go pretty far down there to kind of not incur the wrath of the gods, so to speak. But anyhow, speaking of the... Oh my god, no. Jesus Christ. All because you barely click on the damn port. Woof. Bell fuck that up. So here we are. The completion of our objective. It's gonna take us... It's taken us a long time, but we got a lot of fighting done in this episode and a lot accomplished. So, yeah, there's that. So, we will take Brigantium, and then we will end this episode as it is, as it was, as it forever will be. Long as fuck, and annoying as hell. Yeah. That's that. You know, a part of me is really, like, I know on YouTube, long videos don't do all that well. That's fine, I get that. I understand, I know why. But quite honestly, you know, you can't just fucking pause it. I'm just saying. Especially with these long ones, you can just kind of stop and come back to it. And I believe that they pick up from where you left off sometimes now. I know my girlfriend was saying something about that the other day. She was watching something and just remembers where the fuck you are. Oh, we were watching something on the WWE Network and it just picks up from where you left off. And she mentioned something that they... do that on YouTube sometimes now, or it sometimes happens on YouTube. I don't know how that works all that much. I wouldn't know anything about that. But like I said, I know long videos don't do very well on YouTube, but it's just, honestly, it's the way to go when you play this game. It's very hard to accomplish anything. Otherwise, you're going to be doing an episode of watching me just go through a couple of turns and attack one settlement, maybe. And that's something too. I mean, it's not much I can do about making the battles quicker. I mean, you can do the, you know, fast forward to the shit, if you will. But, you know, quite honestly, sometimes you need to put it on slow-mo to have full control over some of the big battles and stuff when you play this game. But, like I said, I kind of feel bad, but then I don't feel bad. Like I said, you can just always pause it. It's not the end of the world. Like I said, I know this LP is kind of hit or miss sometimes, quite honestly. Sometimes it does pretty well, sometimes it does all right. I know for a fact, though, that the Pokemon does pretty decent. And I know our Lord of the Rings one does pretty well, and that is something, by the way, that we are going to continue doing here this weekend. Like I said, we've got a new... we've started trying to record in a different way because we weren't able to get to recording Lord of the Rings as frequently as we would like, because we want to obviously do that shit consistently. So obviously there's consistent views and some people come to the channel and all that good shit. So, like I said, unfortunately, I'm giving the news now at the end of fucking hour and a half long episode, probably something like that. I don't really watch the time all that much. I don't have a fucking timer over here timing me or anything like that. I don't care that much. Like, as I've said before, this is a game that's tough to put down sometimes. It's hard to find a good spot to stop. And that's kind of where we end up quite often here. And like I said, I kind of set out, this is kind of the way I do my videos in general. I just kind of set out goals, benchmarks, where I want to be at the end of the episode. And however long it takes is how long it takes. That's just the way it ends up sometimes. There's no, like I said, it's probably best, you know, to attract people to the channel by doing, you know, certain time limits on videos and shit like that, but I have a hard time doing that myself. I don't have fun looking at that. And like I said, I mean, you're in the middle of a Pokemon battle. Okay, time to end this episode. Bye. It just doesn't fucking work out. You know what I mean? And like I said, for me, when I play games, I mean, that's something too, like, you gotta understand, this is the way I play games. I don't play games just saying, oh, or I'm going to play for 15 minutes again and then just stop wherever I am. No, I have objectives that I want to accomplish. And, you know, usually that's, you know, figure out, okay, hey, I got to get this far in the game today. That's what I want to do. You know, like I said, that's kind of just the way I play games. You know, I want to accomplish X amount of missions, or I want to get this far in Final Fantasy today, or get to this point in the game, whatever. Like I said, that's how I play games. I have, you know, places that I want to get to, parts that I want to, you know, explore, shit like that. And if you, you know, kind of just set a time limit, it'll take you fucking forever to get there. And, you know, like I said, it's just the way I am when it comes to playing games and shit. So, attack those fuckers. Attack those fuckers. Attack those fuckers. Fuck those guys. Switch your fire over to these little shits over here. Throw your dinkies at them. Throw your little dinkies. Throw your shit. There's a fucking fly in here, and it's pissing me off, by the way. It just keeps flying around the fucking TV, and it's irritating the hell out of me. Really is. Just thought you should know. Yeah, you guys. Go attack. Go attack. You can probably hear Frodo right now in the other room digging fucking dog food out of that goddamn dish. Like I said, the fucker just... goddamn little bastard. It's always into that shit. Always gotta play with something. He's the only cat that I've ever known that plays with shit constantly. Constantly. If he's not sleeping, he's fucking playing. He doesn't sit around, lounge around all that much. He fucking has to have some goddamn object to fucking knock around the goddamn kitchen. Sorry. Something that kind of irritates me. Because I'm trying to, like, get him to quit digging food out of there, because I don't want giant chunks of dog food all over my house all the time. Kind of annoys me. Although, Frodo does eventually eat the dog food. Because apparently when he's done playing with it, he eats it. But it's just... just irritating. Especially when, you know, you're trying to record and you got all that shit dinking around. And now the dog's like, oh, I'm gonna fucking move because I can't sit down today. I don't know what to fucking do with myself. So now my commentary has curtailed into complaining about the myriad of cats and dog that I have in my living room. In my presence right now. Of which there are 1, 2, 3 cats. And the dog just left the room. And I have a frilled lizard in a cage behind me as well. So I thought you should know that. Since it's vital to all the ambient sounds that you get. That's also one of the reasons why the commentary and shit is usually turned down so low. Is so that I don't get all that ambient sound. I know a lot of people... well, not a lot of people. I know you are likely to have to really crank up the sound on your computer and shit to hear us. That's why. It's because, yeah, there's just so much shit going on around here that unless I turn the shit really, really far down, you're going to pick up every little jingling bell on every cat, and every time the damn dog gets up off the couch and lugs her fat ass to her bedroom and then decides to do the exact opposite 5 minutes later when she hauls her fat ass out of the fucking bedroom and then decides to come and lay down on the couch. Yeah. She's being really bad today, by the way. She can't seem to fucking sit the goddamn hell, shit, fuck, down. All the words I can say possibly all at once. She just can't fucking figure herself out tonight, and it irritates the hell out of me. Because it just does. It's the kind of person I am. But anyhow, enough about me. We have now taken Brigantium, and now we have conquered all of the Iberian Peninsula. Good shit. We've accomplished our objective for today. That's about it. That's about all I got for you. Would go a lot quicker, in all honesty, if I would just, you know, skip past all the fighting and not do all the fighting. But I think, like I said, that's kind of the exciting shit when you do the fighting. So that is what it is. The hell, the Sacred Company was founded in Carlos? Holy shit. Did not realize that. Damn, you guys are pissed. Pissed off, people. They might... well, no. Oh, in all honesty. Probably end up bringing... oh, no, they're pissed right now. They's pissed. Tactical fuck. We don't have anything right now for any of these different settlements. We'll go with Trading Port, just because we can. Holy shit. You think they had enough fucking cultural stuff here? They probably had to do that just to keep their fucking people happy. Jesus. Nope, go back. Go back to the settlement. Go back. Click on the fucking settlement. There you go. Destroy that shit. We don't want that shit. No, we don't. Not at all. Alright, anyhow. Hopefully they turn back. It'd be nice to see them turn back, because it does take quite a bit to get up and over that mountain. But we'll see. Since everything should stabilize out here soon, and then, like I said, we'll... This place, Olasipo and shit, will stabilize. Good thing is, Olasipo's really the only place the rebel army can take. Eboro will be pretty well defended, methinks. But anyhow, that does it for this episode. If you made it this far on YouTube, you know what to do. Like, comment, subscribe, all that good shit. Thanks a lot for watching, and next time we will start the campaign in the eastern portion of our territory, or whatever the hell you want to call it. Anyway, bye.